Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Kadan Academy and also one more channel Mechanical Vibration associated with the Kadan Academy. Before start the static dynamic balancing, this is the concept we are going to study in this video. Friends, you will enjoy the movie. What is machine? What are different types of machines in relation with this static and dynamic balancing we are going to study in this video. So first we study basic study related or prerequisite study related to static and dynamic balancing. So what is machine? Machine mein kya hai? Different parts are moving like rotating parts are there or reciprocating parts are there. They are moving in true and pro motion. Due to these movements, what will happen? Due to these motions, there may be high speed or low speed. It will create vibrations. So we'll see some applications of that machine also. We have to balance like these conditions. Before start, we will see what are the forces. Before see the applications of the machines. In this, balancing is necessary, especially in high speed systems or machines such as electric motors or the system which will generate the generator with the electricity or steam turbines are there, power generation units. See, this is the turbine, high speed pressure, steam, generated steam is through this power is generated in this by using turbines, pumps are there. So there also vibrations, or the machine tools, in this also vibration is there. So these are the some examples where the high speed applications are there. Aircrafts or paper mills, you can see here in paper mills also there is a vibration, or blowers are there, there will be balancing is required. In textile machines also the balancing is required. Their rotating and reciprocating parts movements are there, hence it is required the balancing. In sugar industry, pulverizer, turbines, ID fans, FD fans, bottle boiler, they are required the balancing very much highest. Various other domestic applications are there. Inline vertical engine, V-type engine, are there the different types of the engines for the use for the two-wheeler and the four-wheeler cars. Now friend, we'll see before start this study of the static balancing, what is that? What are the different forces? Types of forces, static forces and dynamic forces are there. So these different types of forces, first is the static and dynamic forces. So start with the static forces. Static forces are the forces which are depend on the weight of body. Weight of the body, static forces which is equal to, here you can see, it depend on the weight of body. So friends, it means, what is the meaning? It means the component creates static forces. The weight component, it will create the static force on that system or machine. This force is called static force. Due to this weight, there is some forces are created. These are the static forces. So friend, there may be gravitational force also. So now talk about the dynamic force. Dynamic forces are those forces which depend on acceleration of the body which is in movement. So this dynamic force depends on the acceleration of body. The component in motion, it creates force on machine. And what will happen due to this, that created force due to this motion, the force is created on system or that machine, that we create hammering effects. Continuously hammering effects are there. So that force, we can also call it the inertia force. So dynamic force or inertia force also. So due to this hammering effect of vibration is produced in that machine or this system. So this static force, dynamic forces were studied. Now we'll see the next, due to this overall efficiency of the system, what will happen with this that system of that due to these forces. So this get reduced, efficiency of system get reduced. The life span of machine also get reduced. So if we eliminate such unbalance of system to ensure a smooth and trouble-free smooth operation, which will increasing bearing life and results in better efficiency for the system. The lifespan of machine also reduce, that we can increase. In some cases, what will happen, machine vibration produce is very high. That will lift machine. You can see hence all machine with high speed have concrete foundation. So see here, this is the concrete foundation, are here you can see for the high speed turbines. These are the generators and here is the turbines. They are very high speed. What is the purpose of this concrete foundation? So hence they understood that the forces on the system or machine disturbing machine producer vibrations are there. That foundation absorb all the vibration produced in that machine. Hence damage in machine we can also avoid. This is the supporting for that avoiding the vibration in that machine. So simple thing, concept of balancing the system or machine, what to do? These forces on system or machine we have to eliminate. So we can define by using the balancing. So definition of balancing is what? Balancing is the process of eliminating the effects of the static forces and dynamic forces acting on that machine or system or machine components. So this is the definition of balancing. Now see what is the unbalanced system. So when system is said to be unbalanced, when the system is said to be unbalanced, in any system having one or more rotating masses, if the center of mass of the system does not lie on the axis of the rotation, then system is called unbalanced. How? We'll see in this, does not lie. The center of mass is does not lie on the axis of rotation. You see through this picture, for the in sugar industry there is a fibrizer and this is a rotor on which these various hammers are there. They are like this inside view and front view. We can see these hammers are rotating in different planes, very high speed. What is the speed? You can see here 110 hammers. Tip of this eight, this is the length of this dimension for this hammer. Tiffany engineering, 700 bsp, 690 rpm swing hammer type, anvil type vibrator is there. So this is one of the practical example to you. They are rotating with the speed 690 rpm by using the drive, that may be the turbine or the motor. So in this case, if you see one rotor and this is the shaft, okay, here shaft on which the disc or rotating mass is there, what will happen when there is the unbalance? This is the axis of rotation. The CG is not on the axis of rotation. In that case, unbalance will be there. This is the front side and this is the side view for this one. How that the CG with having centrifugal force acting on this rotor, which CG at a distance of R, means what? Here you can see from the side view what is the meaning of this unbalance. From this figure it will be clear to you. One rotor is mounted on shaft and that shaft is having rotating with his own axis of rotation. The CG of rotor of this figure is at the distance of R. You can see here small r, thoda dur hai, it's not close to the center of the axis of rotation. Here it's away from this center of axis of rotation. So what will happen from this axis, when this rotor start rotating, this centrifugal force, this Fc is equal to mr omega square, or we can say mv square by r. This is acting outward side. This is clear to in side view. This centrifugal force is towards outside, bahar ke side mein, bahar ke side. Due to this, what will happen? The system get unbalanced. It will get create vibrations also. So what we have to do? So we will see how the unbalanced systems are unbalanced now. The first with the, we have to create the balancing. So first we have to start with the static balancing in this case. In the static balancing, what will happen? The system is said to be statistically balanced. If there is a CG of the system, mass will be lie on the axis of rotation. It means that if your system is lie on the axis of rotation, so it will get balanced. But how it is possible? For this purpose, what we will do? Apply one force here, that you can see here, this red color is given. The another force is applied the opposite direction, same quantity. The system is said to be statistically balanced, unbalanced, and CG of mass we have to keep on the axis. But how it is possible? By putting the one mass of same magnitude but in opposite direction. So what will happen? The summation of this force, that will be addition will get here reduced. You can see in this diagram also, this axis of rotation, yes, CG is away from at a distance of r, is not on the axis of rotation. So here is the vibration is created. So we have to create the balancing. What is the condition? Then the resultant of all the dynamic forces, centrifugal forces acting on the system during the rotation must be zero. So when this we added the centrifugal forces acting on the system, that will be equal to zero. That means plus mr omega square minus mr omega square, that will be addition of this become zero. The minus sign shows that the force is applied in that figure, it is in opposite direction but same magnitude, it will become zero. So this is the one static balancing with the condition. The resultant of all dynamic forces, that is the centrifugal forces acting on the system during the rotation, must be zero. That is the summation of centrifugal forces acting on the system is zero. Now we'll go for the dynamic balancing. Here, what will happen? We'll see. This is a rotor, is continuously rotating. You can also see these green color arrows. Watch it carefully. Hence the balance system, one's condition is that the resultant of all the dynamic forces of the acting on the system will be zero. But how it is possible in this case? See, this is a figure. Centrifugal forces applied on this rotor try to shift CG, divert the CG toward the axis of rotation. Already we have studied. So for this figure or diagram, these two forces are there. So what will happen due to this one? That will try to create one couple. This magnitude of this couples, these forces are there at the end of this both the, that will try to create one couple. So friends, now this figure is clear, statistically balanced, already we have studied. Here applied force at each end. Now what is the difference? What is the, therefore the forces having some magnitude but in opposite direction they are creating the couple. So what is the couple? We'll see here. This couple we have to solve it for this dynamic balancing. In the same figure, in the second figure already we have seen that the static balancing already we have studied. The resultant for centrifugal, forces are there, centrifugal forces or dynamic forces are zero. In the second condition, in dynamic balancing, the second condition is what? The resultant of couples due to all dynamic forces or centrifugal forces acting on the system during the rotation about the any plane must be zero. Means addition of this couple, that will become zero. The summation of all the couples, that will be zero. So hence we can solve these static balancing equations or numericals by using the this condition, first condition. For dynamic balancing, we have to first solve the static balancing condition, and second condition, the summation of all the couples becomes zero. So these are the few concepts of static balancing, dynamic balancing. So friends, this dynamic balancing, how we can control? The center of mass CG of the system must be lie on the axis of rotation. This is the first condition. The resultant couple due to the dynamic and centrifugal forces due to action of inertial forces acting on the system when rotation should be zero, that means the summation of couple becomes zero. So already we have seen this. And what will happen if not unbalanced? It will get vibratory behavior. So to avoid this, we have to balance this system. Friends, this is the concept we have studied. Why balancing is so important, friend? A level of unbalance that is acceptable at a low speed, but it completely unacceptable at high speed. As machine get bigger and so faster, the effect of unbalance more severe. The force caused by unbalance increases by square of the speed. If the speed is double, the force quadruple. If the speed is triple, force is increases by factor of 9. So friend, that's why the balancing is important. So thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe my channel, Kadam Academy and Mechanical Vibration.